गुड इवनिंग सर।
वेरी गुड इवनिंग बेटा।
गुड इवनिंग सर।
गुड इवनिंग। गुड इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग सर।
वेरी गुड इवनिंग बेटा।
ओके सो हियर वी हैव आवर नोट्स दैट यू विल गेट टुडे इटसेल्फ आफ्टर द क्लास। ओके यू विल गेट योर नोट्स ऑन योर device. Okay, so we'll discuss about the material, then metal and non-metals. So somebody is in waiting room? No, nobody is in waiting room. Okay, see, first we have to discuss about what is metal. We have already been discussed. Okay, what is metal basically? So what is metal?
Matter is anything that occupies space. Yes,
anything around us which have mass and occupies space is called as matter. Okay, it's called as matter. And we know matters are formed by the smallest indivisible particles called atom. Okay, see, we had discussed one theory of Rishi Kanad. Is it? You know who is Rishi Kanad?
Yes,
about 600 BC. About 600 BC. BC means before Christ. Okay, so like when
sir, can you repeat the name?
BC means before Christ. Okay, it is the time, okay, when the God of the Christian called Isa Masih, he has born, okay, 600 year before that particular time is called as 600 BC. Okay, there was one.
Cousin, what is the full form of AD? Because in some days I think that 600
AD means Anno Domini, sir.
Yes. See, we have BC again. See. We have to discuss about Rishi Kanad. So let complete me first, then we will discuss other topics also. Okay, but we have to stick with our syllabus. Then we are going to complete our syllabus in a time. Otherwise, we will discuss irrelevant things, and our syllabus will not going to complete in given period of time. Okay. So in about 600 BC, there was one Indian saint called Rishi Kanad. Rishi Kanad. Okay. He observed, matter around us, and he, performed many experiments to understand what are, how these matters or maybe object they are formed by. Okay. So he found that he, took one of the leaf of the plant. Okay. And he breaks down this leaf into two parts. Okay. Two equal parts. And he, and he performed this activity again and again and again. Okay. And finally, he reached at that particular situation that particle is, not going to divide again. This particle is nothing but the indivisible particle. Indivisible particle. Okay, so he, he becomes curious whether all the matters around him are formed by such indivisible particles or not. Okay, or not. So he again, put some piece of the soil and he performed the same experiment. He breaks down into every time in a half part, and he reached that particular, particle where he cannot divide that particular particle. Then he performed many experiments around us, whatever object he found. Okay. So every time he reached that particular particle, which is indivisible. So he described that every matter around us, they are formed by such small particles or some indivisible particles. And he named that small particle as Parmanu. Okay, and this Parmanu we are studying as atom today.
Yes. So he's also known as father of atomic theory. So he's also known as the father of atomic theory.
See what happens. Our research, they are not, see, whatever we will discover today or we will research nowadays, we have to make patent, okay, so that nobody will going to copy our research. But that time there was no such type of patent, so that's why Rishi Kanad is not being heard by most of the student of India. But we have to discuss about the Rishi Kanad and his
Sir, I didn't understand what you said.
See, what happens? Suppose you become a scientist and you discovered one of the compound. Okay. So if this compound is new for the world, then you have to, register that particular compound on your name. This process is called as patent. Okay. So that time there was not such facilities were available. That's why Rishi Kanad is not well known about today's science. In today's science.
Yes, sir. Father of atomic theory is John Dalton.
Yes, John Dalton. John Dalton was there. Okay. But really, Rishi Kanad was the one who discovered the atom and he named that atom as Parmanu. Okay. Now, then different scientists, they came and they performed the same experiments after Rishi Kanad and they described this in the same way. That the smallest particle
I just discovered it, but it was invented long time ago.
Yes, we can say that. Okay, so here we have, see, all the matters, they are formed by such small particles called atom. Okay, see here, matter are formed by the smallest and indivisible particles called atoms. Okay, and if we will observe about the particles of plant leaf, these small particles will be different. Then if you will find the particles of the stone, soil, bark of the tree, okay? So all other objects like fiber, we have pen, we have laptop, glass, whatever we have, okay? So every, different type of object, they are formed by the different type of particles. Here we have that point for it. Different matters around us are formed by different type of atoms. Okay, like if we will discuss about the iron. So iron have all the atoms made up of the iron only, ferrous. Okay, if we will discuss about the rice. Okay, so rice, the seed that we are using every day in our diet, rice. Okay, it is formed by the small particles of the carbohydrate. Okay, and if we'll discuss about the fiber, plastic, okay, so they are formed by the small molecules called hydrocarbons. Okay, so if we'll discuss about the water molecule, water, it is again formed by the small particles or molecule called H2O. Okay, so all the other matters around us, they are formed by the such small particles. They may be atom, they may be molecule. Okay, like this. Matters generally exist in three basic states at a normal temperature and pressure. And we are discussing about the normal temperature and pressure. And these states are solid, liquid, and gaseous state. Okay. These states are solid, liquid, and gaseous state. So everything around us is categorized into their either metal or non-metal. But we have one more category, okay, and which is metalloid, that we have already been discussed. Okay, hence it is important to know that non-metals and metals are and how to distinguish them. And now we will discuss how these elements are classified as metal, non-metal, and metalloids. We will discuss definitely. Okay, so till here in material and yes, beta.
Sir, can we observe that atoms under a microscope?
No. If we have, if we want to observe atoms, we have to use electron microscope for that.
Microscope, sir.
We will use electron microscope. By using microscope, we can, observe the single cellular organism like our amoeba is there, paramecium is there, bacterial.
So what is the difference between the microscope and the electron microscope?
See, electron microscope, it is again a kind of microscope, but it, you know, it magnifying the object very large extent. We can observe, you know, the small atoms also.
That means we can also see inside the cells, right?
Amoeba.
We have to increase. Amoeba is a one single cellular organism. Paramecium. Yes. We can observe single cellular organism with the help of simple microscope. We called it compound microscope. But
sir, I'm asking, like electron microscope, can we see objects which are smaller than amoeba?
Electron microscope. See, I think the smallest, you know, organism in our surrounding are virus, bacteria, and the primitive cells like amoeba and paramecium. So by using electron microscope, we can observe the particles which are, you know, amoeba and these single cellular organisms are formed. We can say observe the single particle, because this amoeba also formed by the many different type of atoms. Because amoeba is performing all the life processes activity by using one cell only. That means amoeba is also formed by the many other types of atoms in it.
Yes, sir.
So, amoeba contain many different types of atom. Okay.
Okay.
So to observe atom, see, we had understood about what atom contain. It contain proton, electron, and neutron. And we have given the structure of atom, like in center we have proton and neutron. Okay. And that particular part of the atom is called as nucleus. It is present at the center of atom, and on different orbit which is away from the nucleus, electrons are revolving continuously around the nucleus. Okay. So that structure of atom is again designed by the different scientists, which is nothing but the hypothetical structure.
Yes, sir. Goldstein, Rutherford.
Yes. Goldstein there. Yes. Rutherford is there. Then John Dalton. Different scientists, they have performed different type of experiments, like scattering of alpha particles. On that basis, they have decides the, you know, the particular atom is and their structure, and they contain proton, electron, neutron, like this.
Sir, They didn't observe the real structure.
The whatever the structure we are, you know, studying today are the hypothetical structure only. Like at the center, proton and neutrons are present. Protons are positive and neutrons are negatively charged particles. And in different orbitals, here electrons are revolving continuously around the nucleus. So these structure are nothing but the hypothetical structure. Okay.
Yes, sir. John Dalton didn't discover the atom, sir. He just discovered how the atomic power will work, sir.
See, we will discuss in detail about the structure of atom. Don't worry. Okay? Don't worry. We will discuss the, you know, history of the discovering of the atom also. We will discuss about the Chadwick model of the atom. Then we will discuss about the John Dalton was there. We will discuss about the Aufbau theory. We will discuss everything. Don't worry. But one by one, in a single day, we cannot, you know, study all the things together. So we have to again stick with our syllabus, whatever we have in.
Sir, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Okay. So we'll move further. Okay. So in our 8th class syllabus, okay, in this chapter, we are going to discuss on the various physical and chemical properties. Various physical and chemical properties of the metal and non-metal. Okay, then it will help you with it. We are list of the few physical and chemical properties of the metal and non-metal. We will discuss in the same chapter only. Okay, so now we are going to start about the metal. So before going to understand the metal, we had to, you know, understand one concept behind how atoms are classified into metal and non-metals. Okay. So first we had to understand about the valency. Okay. So you know what is valency? Anybody, any idea about valency?
No, sir.
Yes, sir. The amount of electrons an atom can give or donate or accept in order to form the complete the octet rule is called as its valency.
Yes.
Sir, like hydrogen has four atoms, so it can give away two atoms and take two
hydrogen,
atoms.
Hydrogen having only one electron, na?
Yes, sir. So,
its valency is one. Let me explain you. Okay. So valency is nothing but the combining capacity of an element. The combining capacity of an element. Okay. So the combining capacity of an element is called as its valency. Is called as its valency. Okay, and valency is determined by number of electrons
in the outer or the valence shell.
Yes, electron present in outermost shell, it is also called as valence shell. Okay, outermost shell or valence shell is called as valency. Okay, I think somebody is in meeting room. But wait 1 minute, I'll just come. Wait, just.
Like for example.
Is written work is done?
1 minute, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir, I wrote it.
Okay, see.
1 minute.
I'm just scrolling little up. Okay, will do? Visible? See.
Yes, sir.
See, we have, discussed here, valence is determined by number of electrons present in outermost shell of an atom. Okay? It is nothing but the valency. Valency determined by number of electrons present in outermost shell. Outermost shell of an atom. We have to write here of an atom. Okay. Outermost shell of an atom. Okay. That means we will decide how much the valency of an element. Okay. So for that, we will take one more example. Suppose we have to read one more rule called octet rule. Octet rule. Okay. Octet rule says to acquire stability. Okay. To become stable. Every element must have 8 electron in their outermost shell. Okay, except first cell. First cell contain only 2 electron, so it is come under duplex rule. Okay, but here we are discussing about the octet rule. Okay, octet. Oct means 8. Oct means 8. So we'll take example of sodium metal. So we have sodium metal. And
can you explain the octet rule again?
See, every element or atom must have 8 electron in their outermost shell in order to acquire stability. Okay, so to become stable, every element must have 8 electron in their outermost shell. Okay, so now we will discuss about the sodium metal. See, sodium metal have its atomic number 11. You know, na?
Yes, sir, 11.
Yes. So from 11 electron, 2 electrons comes in first cell, then 8 electron comes on second cell, and in third cell we have only 1 electron.
1.
Yes. Okay, 1 electron. So see what happens. What octet rule is saying? 8 electron have to be in their outermost cell, but in outermost cell of sodium we have only 1 electron. So sodium have now 2 conditions. Sodium have 2 conditions. Either sodium is going to lose 1 electron, or it may gain 7 electron. See, there are 2 conditions. If electron will lose by the sodium, then this shell will get omitted, means sodium will have only 2 and 8, so, and this cell will become outermost cell, and at this state it will have 8 electron in its outermost shell, and that means
have a doubt.
Yes, listen, explain me first. Okay, this is the first condition. This is the first condition. And second condition, sodium may have to gain 7 electron. Have to gain 7 electron, but to gain 7 electron is require more energy, and the sodium metal will become more unstable. So sodium will lose 1 electron easily in order to form sodium ion. So here we have sodium with 11 electron. It is going to lose 1 electron. See, 1 electron is lost by the sodium. Now sodium will have only 10 electron. Okay, so after 10 electron will acquire positive charge. Okay, so this is the sodium ion. This is the sodium ion which is formed by the loss of electron. See, here that means sodium have valency 1. That means sodium have valency 1. Understood? Yes, what is your doubt, beta? Your name?
Yes, sir, understood.
Sir, if it loses 1 electron or gains 7 electrons, does it change the pattern of the matter?
Whenever the electron are lost or gained by the atom, see, another atom, suppose sodium is going to lose 1 electron, means there will be another atom with going to gain 1 electron which is lost by sodium. So another metal will form negative ion, and the sodium metal will form positive ion. So those both the ions, they are going to combine to form product like NaCl, sodium chloride, we are using every day in our daily diet. Okay, that sodium chloride is formed by the loss of 1 electron by sodium, and that electron which was lost by the sodium is gained by the chlorine atom. So chlorine, when gains electron, is formed negative ion, and due to loss of sodium electron, sodium forms positive ion. So positive and negative ion, they combines each other to form electrovalent bond. Okay, and that electrovalent bond result into the formation of sodium chloride, and that sodium chloride we are using every day, which is a salt. We are using in our daily diet for cooking vegetables.
Forming the chemical formula of salt, chlorine has valency 1- and sodium has 1+.
See,
they will interchange, so 1-1 will get cancelled and it will be NaCl. So
yes, NaCl is a neutral bond. No, it is electrovalent bond. It is also called as ionic bond. We will discuss later. We have, you know, one topic in our this chapter about the ionic compound. There we will discuss in detail. Let's discuss only about valency here. All your questions,
sir, in the first shell there are 2 electrons,
yes.
Second 8,
Yes.
The third, it should be 18
electron.
We so, sir, why only 8? There are.
See, it is 8. It is only to acquire stability, to become stable. Okay, see, you having desire to have 1 lakh rupees salary per month, but let me explain first. Okay, see, somebody is having desire to have 1 lakh rupees per month, but if it becomes stable, when he will receive 50,000 salary also. So 1 lakh salary is desire, but to complete the basic needs, 50,000 is also sufficient. Okay, so in order to acquire stability, 50,000 is also sufficient. Now that's why the same thing is here. In third cell, element must have 18 electron, but the scientist they explains that if 8 electrons are present in outermost shell of an atom, then it also becomes stable. Understood?
Yes, sir. Yes, understood.
Sir. Yes.
Total, how many electrons should be in an atom to acquire stability?
In outermost shell, 8 electrons must be present, except first cell. Because in first cell, only 2 electrons are present and the atoms become stable. But when the second cell comes, there must be 8 electrons. Okay? Now, so we are discussing about the valency here. Okay? So, see here, sodium loses 1 electron in order to acquire stability, is it? So, those elements having tendency to lose electron are called as metals. Understood? Metals? Elements having tendency to lose electron, and when they lose electron, they form positive ions. Okay? Such atoms or elements are called as metals. I am here explaining everything to make you understand about what are metals. So metals are the element having tendency to lose electron. Okay, understood, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here we have definition of metal. Metal are described as the chemical element that readily lose valence electron to form the positive ion. And positive ions are called as cations. Okay. Positive ions are called as cations. Okay. So we have written one more definition in red color. Okay. What is it? Element having tendency to lose electron from their valence shell to form positive ions, means cation, are called as metals. Are called as metals. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
so, example. So, can you repeat the definition of metal? Elements having loose tendency?
Will you please repeat your question? Pallav?
Sir, I didn't ask the question.
Sir, can you please repeat the...
Can you please repeat
the definition of...
Metals.
Metal.
See, it is written on your screen, in red color here. We have element having tendency to lose electrons from their valence shell, or we can say outermost shell also, okay, to form positive ions, and positive ions are called as cations, okay, and such elements are called as metals.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Then we have example like aluminium. If you will discuss about the aluminium, see, aluminium have atomic number 13. Okay, aluminium have atomic number 13. Again, we are going to write the electronic configuration. In first cell, aluminium have 2 electron. In second cell, aluminium have 8 electron. And in outermost cell, aluminium have only 3 electron. See, again, 3 electron. Again, there are 2 conditions. Whether aluminium is going to lose 3 electron or may gain
5 electrons.
To gain 5 electron will become difficult for aluminium. Hence, it will easily lose 3 electron. That means its valency is 3. Its valency is 3. And when it is...
How 5 electron gain?
I
did not understand. Gain 5.
5 electrons. How sir?
See, there are two possibilities.
What happens, sir?
See, it is the metal. It is the metal and will not going to gain electron. Okay, because metal always loses electron.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Sir, metal always loses electron and yes. Non-metals accept electron. Yes. So what yes. do metal?
Metalloids have depends. Suppose you are what is your name, beta?
Shahu.
Shahu. S-A-H-O-O.
S-H-A-H-U.
S-H-A-H-U. See, Shahu, what happens? See, Shahu has two different friends. Okay. One is from Ambani's family. Ambani's family, okay, and one is from the village, and that village friend is very poor, and Ambani's we know very rich, okay. So the one of the friend, see, suppose its name is X, okay. So X is poor, and Ambani's friend, let its name is Y. Okay, so X is very poor. So X invited Shahu, okay, to come his to visit his village because he is having some festival. So Shahu came to village of the X, okay, and he told that X that we are going to eat something because he traveled from the very long distance, so he had to eat something. So X told, so they are having breakfast, lunch in a hotel. So just let me know who is going to pay the bill, this X or Shahu?
Shahu.
Yes. Why? Because the X is very poor. Let another condition. Shahu is going to meet again Ambani's family, and Ambani's are millionaires, multi-millionaires we can say, okay, and they shop many things from the mall. So who is going to pay the bill? Ambani's why or
Ambani?
Yes. See, so Shahu may lose his electron or may gain electron. It depends on the element who is going to combine it with. Okay, so Shahu, we can say act as a metal and sometimes act as a non-metal. Okay, so such elements, they are described as metalloids. So we can say Shahu, okay, whether it is going to lose electron or it is going to gain electron, it depends on the metal who is going to bind with Shahu. Is it or not? So we can say here Shahu is acting as a both metal as well as non-metal, but it depends on the condition only. Okay, so such elements are called as metalloids. That's why we are defining metalloid as elements having properties of both metal as well as non-metals, or intermediate property of metal and non-metal are called as metalloids. Understood, beta?
Yes, sir. Understood. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. Yes, sir. So let's see. We have only 2 minutes. After 2 minutes, we will disconnect and we will reconnect once. Okay. So, example, aluminium, copper,
yes,
iron, tin, gold, we have, we had discussed about the sodium, potassium, all these are metals, okay? And around 90 of the total, 90 elements, they are metals from 118 elements of our modern periodic table. So, 90 are metals, okay? Out of 118 elements that we have in our periodic table. Okay, understood?
Yes, sir, understood.
Okay, so now I'm going to disconnect and then we will reconnect because we have only 2 minutes left. Okay, so then we will discuss about what are, again, metals and their examples also. We will discuss about the physical properties also. Okay, so I'm going to disconnect, sir. Now, then we will reconnect once. So
okay,
I want,
sir.
You all have to join or rejoin within a minute, okay?
Okay,
yes,
sir. Sir, when you will send these notes?
Today after the class.
Okay, sir. Sir, in the classroom, I have group.
In your WhatsApp group also, even I'm going to, you know, upload on your Google Classroom also. Don't worry.
Sir, can we submit our written notes in Google Classroom?
Google Classroom, you have to discuss with Manu sir. If you can access the Google Classroom from there or not. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So, we'll meet within a minute, okay? All I want you to join within a minute. Okay, bye.
Okay, sir.